I am Erin Carlson Mast. I'm the executive director and CEO of President Lincoln's Cottage in Washington, D.C. We're only 3 miles north of the White House, but we are 300 feet above sea level, which in Washington, D.C. is a huge difference in climate. So one of the main reasons the Lincoln family was coming out here is that it was considered a healthier place. The Soldiers Home campus was actually similar in size to what it was during the Civil War era when Lincoln was living here. It's about 250 acres. And there are four buildings that comprise what we call the historic core, which were here during Lincoln's time. So of course the cottage is one of those. And then there were two other officers' quarters. And then there was the main Soldiers Home building. And in that building, which is right next to the cottage, as you can see, there were at least 100 veterans living there. President Lincoln's cottage is where Abraham Lincoln lived and worked for over a quarter of his presidency. It's where he was residing when he made some of his most momentous decisions of the Civil War. For example, the very first summer in residence, he was drafting the Emancipation Proclamation, which he issued while he was still living here. One of our favorite rooms here is the library. There are a lot of stories of Lincoln, either people coming upon him reading by himself, or stories of him reading aloud to other people who were visiting him here. And so the books he was reading, whether it was works of Shakespeare that focus on tyrants or wars, or whether it was political satire, which we know was an outlet for Lincoln, the fact that he was such a voracious reader and that this library really illustrates that is something that was important for us to capture as well. We're in the room that's known as the Emancipation Room because over 100 years ago, when the cottage was threatened, local preservationists said, we need to save the cottage because it's where Lincoln drafted the Emancipation Proclamation, and he did it in that room in the house. And we don't know whether that's exactly true. It's certainly the oral history associated with this place. The original desk is now at the White House, and while they did not give it back, they gave us an exception and allowed us to make a replica of it, which they don't normally do. During the Civil War, it became immediately clear that the Army had a major problem on its hands, and that's what to do with all the Civil War dead. And one of the places they landed on was the already existing Soldiers' Home Cemetery. And over the course of the Civil War, over 6,000 soldiers were buried in that cemetery. The first season the Lincolns were in residence, over 1,000 soldiers were buried there in plain view. So while it's tempting to think of this place as this beautiful pastoral retreat for Lincoln and his family, the fact of the matter is he was confronting the results of his decisions as commander-in-chief on a daily basis. And he wasn't avoiding it. You know, it was something that he was seeing, and he had to face that reality, and he wasn't shying away from it.